Thank you. Very beautiful.
Thank you.
It's from your new CD, yes. Wind.
Yeah.
Thanks for coming from Paris, by the way. That's where you live.
Thank you for inviting me.
Glad that you were here. You were born in Beirut.
Yeah.
And you live in Paris. First of all, is the trumpet a really popular instrument in the Arabic world? Or
in Arabic world, not at all, actually. Uh-huh. Basically, trumpet is well known for military music and for, when somebody dies or okay. this kind of mm-hmm. stuff.
Funeral.
So it's not at all an uh-huh. instrument that people usually use. Uh-huh. They're usually more on guitar and okay. piano.
So living in Beirut, when did you pick up the trumpet?
I was born in Beirut and I was born in the middle of the civil war. So my parents decided to move to France so that we're more secure mm-hmm. there. And I grew up in the suburb of Paris, in what we call the banlieue of Paris.
Yeah.
And I grew up there and my father is a trumpet player and my mother is a piano player. And very fast, when I was young, around 7 years old, I said to my father, I want to play this instrument. So he gave me a trumpet and I started very early at that
So moment. How old were you when you left from Beirut? Then?
I was very small. I don't even
okay.
remember.
Oh, you remember.
I was
okay.
very, like, probably between 1 and 2 years old.
Uh-huh.
We used to go to France and go back to Lebanon many times because during this period, the people were living under the bombs. So nobody knew it would last so long. Most of the people thought it would last maybe just a few days, few hours maybe even,
Yeah.
And it's a bit like what's happening in Syria, unfortunately, now.
Yeah.
People don't expect it to last, but it's lasting more and more. And 17 years. So when my parents moved to France, they probably were expecting just to stay a few months, but it lasted the whole life.
But your father was already a trumpet player in Lebanon?
Yes,
in Beirut.
He studied okay. in France with okay. Maurice André, which
yes.
who was the, mm-hmm. the soloist in
yes.
classical music.
Yes.
And he also invented the trumpet I'm playing, which is the quarter tone trumpet in the 60s, back in the 60s in France. And then he moved back to Lebanon in the beginning of the 70s to work there. He was trumpet player of the National Orchestra. He was teacher at the okay. Conservatoire of Beirut before the war. And then 5-6 years later, the war started and everything was all upset.
Uh-huh.
And then,
And your father invented?
This trumpet.
This
yes.
trumpet, huh?
Yeah, exactly.
Could you show it and
yeah,
how does it work?
It's a normal trumpet. Mm-hmm. Usually trumpets, they have only the three valves here. And he added this one. And with this one, you can do quarter tones. So this, and in Arabic music, there are quarter tones. So it was almost impossible to play Arabic music on trumpet. Yeah.
Can you give an example on your album?
Yeah, of course. Well, actually, what we just played now,
mm-hmm.
When I do... this is what we call an Arabic scale. I mean, it's a maqam.
Yeah. Yeah, but normally you do that with your... embouchure or
yeah,
what? Or
you can do it a little bit like, but it's not very natural. The instrument doesn't allow it naturally.
Yeah.
So this makes it very natural and
yeah.
easy.
In all your work, it's a very strong influence. The Arabic music.
Yeah, Arabic. Yeah, it's everywhere in all
mm-hmm.
the compositions and. Definitely everywhere in everything I do.
Yeah.
I guess it's like an accent, right?
Uh-huh. Yeah. But you see also as kind of a mission, or is that to...
No. I've never seen this as a mission. Actually, I don't consider myself as a trumpet player, but more as a composer.
Of course.
And I use the trumpet as an instrument, to compose.
Yeah.
And in my compositions, there is always all the things that I like, all the things that I like to listen to, all the parts of my, what they call my identity,
Yeah. You were raised and grew up as a classical trumpet player.
Yes. Eh?
You studied at the conservatory. You won
yes.
a lot of competitions. I saw. It's amazing.
Yeah.
when did you decide to, let's say, leave the classical world and go in your own world, so to speak?
I wouldn't say I have ever left
it.
Classical music. I still play classical music, but after 20 years of trumpet playing and playing the classical pieces and Bach and Haydn and all those things, I felt that it will not be something that I will enjoy doing all my life, only
mm-hmm.
to be interpreting other people's music.
Okay.
So now what I do with classical music is that I'm very lucky because since many years now I compose music for a classical style, like what they say, contemporary classical music, for a trumpet and orchestras or choirs or this kind of things, and I play them on trumpet. So it's like in the same time combining what I love in classical and contemporary music or romantic music, baroque music, with this.
Yeah. Is it also an advantage still that you studied classical before this, or?
Yes, of course, of course, because the it gives you rails, you know, it gives you some kind of confidence because you really control the instrument. You have been working a lot on this instrument, you know, like for competitions, there's not one note that should be higher or lower or mistake and this kind of, so everything is very, very strict. So it gives you some kind of, how do you say, confidence in your work. But then it doesn't become a rule for me. I mean, classical music doesn't rule everything in what I do, even if I really respect it a lot. Yeah.
Another piece from your new album, Wind, what's going to be?
It's Questions and Answers.
Yes. With a beautiful ending, I have to say.
Thank you.